Welcome to Show's World Gamers, Josh here, and in last week's Week in Review video, which drops every Friday and contains info on the previous week's game releases, announcements, and gaming news, we briefly touched on the new Netflix Resident Evil live-action series. Now, I spent the weekend watching the series, which includes 8 episodes ranging from around 45 minutes to an hour. This is a new side independent storyline and doesn't directly follow any of the games. I'm not going to delve too deep into the story, as I want to keep this spoiler-free in case you do decide to check it out on your own. There are 2 intertwining storylines, one that takes place in 2022, and the other takes place 14 years later in 2036. The first half of the season is really carried by the 2022 timeline, and the series jumps back and forth between the two quite a lot. Around the midpoint of the season, the 2036 timeline becomes more interesting and takes over the bulk of the series going forward until the final few episodes, where both timelines really ramp up and bounce back and forth continuously until the credits roll. There is some gore, but it isn't bursts, with familiar monsters in some truly terrifying scenes. Unfortunately, these moments are just far too few. One place where the series really shines is with the cast. From the main cast to the secondary and support cast, there are some fun and memorable characters brought to life by some stellar acting. Lance Riddick is absolutely fantastic and by far the best part of this first season. The storyline itself is just okay. The Rotten Tomatoes scores last I checked were 50% rotten by critics and an abysmal 26% audience score, which I do think is a little harsh. I did enjoy the series more than I expected I would. For a first season, it did a good job introducing new characters and pointing us in an interesting direction. But unfortunately, with the reviews we have gotten, I would be surprised if this didn't end up a one-off. Which, if that turns out to be the case, is disappointing, as I do feel there was something to build off of here. So, should you watch it or pass? I say, if you have some extra time, it can be a fun watch. It's only 8 episodes, and the actors carry a so-so storyline. Now, there is one thing in this series that I just have to bring it up. There is a part in the series where Ella Balinskas, I think that's how you pronounce her last name. I'm sure I got that wrong. But anyways, her character Jade gets put in a cell, and I can't help but just wonder, what is going on here? Is this a joke? A little homage to some of the ridiculous video game rules we have to accept and ignore to not ruin the ambiance of our games, like that line of 1-foot-tall bushes used as a barrier, because the bars on the cell are so far apart, I'm pretty sure she could walk through without even touching either side. I really want to believe this was purposely done and not just a ridiculous oversight. I know they don't want to make them too close as it makes filming harder, but this is just insane. Anyways, gamers, I just had to point that out, but what did you guys think about the series, if you watched it? And if not, are you going to give it a chance? Let me know in the comments. Also, like the video, and if you're not subscribed, subscribe to the channel for more gaming content. Thanks for joining us today, gamers. Show's World, out.